Hello, my name is Anastas Papagiannis and I'm going to present our work with title Memory Mapped Ion Steroids. This is a joint work with Manolis Marazakis and Angelos Bilas, who is also my PhD advisor. Today, the majority of storage devices are block addressable. These include traditional hard disk drives, but also fast storage devices like flash. This will not change anytime soon due to capacity and cost reasons. Block addressable storage devices require I/O caching over DRAM for several reasons. These include performance, because DRAM is much faster compared to persistent storage, and also granularity, as applications tend to access data in a world rather than block granularity. The introduction of emerging fast storage devices aggravates storage caching issues. First, the heat path requires expensive software cache lookups, and this results to spending many more precious CPU cycles for cache management rather than user processing. Additionally, in storage caches, one size does not fit all. As an example, applications use specific techniques to reduce small random writes. They separate reads and writes for cache pollution purposes and other application-specific optimizations. Memory mapped I/O has the potential to solve these issues. In memory mapped I/O, a file or device is mapped to a process virtual address space. Applications can use process lodestone instructions in order to access data. In this case, the kernel is responsible to fetch and evict pages on demand. In memory mapped I/O, hits are handled entirely in hardware through the memory management unit and the TLB. In the case of a TLB miss, an additional page table walk is also required. As hits are handled entirely in hardware, this provides less overheads compared to software cache lookups. On the other hand, misses require a page fault instead of a system call, and this introduces additional overheads. The 4 kilobyte page size that a page fault relies on also results in small and random I/Os. Another issue is that Linux memory mapped I/O does not allow customization as it relies on the Linux pages. Because of these issues, today user applications prefer to do I/O caching with system calls. Next, we provide the common ways to do storage caching today. A kernel space cache, as we see on the left figure, requires system calls for hits. On the other hand, I/O does not require any system calls. A kernel space cache contains raw serialized device blocks. On the other hand, as we see on the right figure, a user space cache requires cache lookups in the case of hits and system calls only for misses. It is generally used to store application-specific deserialized data. To avoid system calls for hits and enable customization, today applications tend to use a user space cache. However, it still requires system calls for misses. On the other hand, software cache lookups in the common path introduce overheads, especially in the case of fast storage devices. This table summarizes the benefits and drawbacks of different ways to do storage caching today. First, in terms of the heat cost, a kernel space cache requires system calls for heats. A user space cache removes the need for system calls. Linux mmap provides the lowest overheads as heats are handled entirely in hardware. The miss cost with a kernel space cache is high due to the system calls. A user space cache can remove system calls by using dedicated storage devices and user space I/O frameworks. With Linux mmap, the miss cost requires an expensive page fault. Finally, the kernel space cache and Linux mmap rely on the Linux buffer cache and the I/O stack. Both of these are not customizable based on application needs. A user space cache enables the use of custom caching policies and ways to access storage devices. Our work, named Aquila, overcomes all of the Linux mmap disadvantages. We leverage the efficient heat path of memory mapped I/O, and we provide an optimized miss path that removes the need for protection domain switches. We also enable customization, DRAM caching, and device access similar to user space cache. Our approach combines the advantages of a user space cache and memory mapped I/O. Aquila is a novel memory mapped I/O path that collocates the user application and memory mapped I/O path in a high privileged domain, non-root ring zero in Intel terminology. Our approach requires minimal application modifications and provides strong protection semantics similar to Linux memory mapped I/O. Aquila allows user applications to customize the DRAM caching and device access based on application needs. Our approach also reduces significantly software overheads in the memory mapped I/O path. This is the outline of my talk. Now I'm going to provide more details about the design of Aquila. We observe that cache management with memory mapped I/O requires several distinct operations. The first operation during the heat path uses load store instructions that are handled entirely in hardware through the memory management unit. For this reason, the heat path does not result in any software overheats. On the other hand, the miss path requires virtual address space manipulation, which also includes page faults. The second operation includes the DRAM cache management in the case of a miss. First, it checks if the page already exists in DRAM and also handles evictions and writebacks. The third operation includes data transfers between the device and DRAM. The fourth operation is a management operation. In memory mapped I/O, it includes file or device mappings that are handled by mmap and mmap system calls. The last operation is physical memory management, which also includes the dynamic resizing of the DRAM cache. In Linux, all of these operations happen inside the operating system and require a protection domain switch from the user to kernel space. The miss path over memory mapped I/O is expensive. In order to quantify these overheads, we provide an execution time breakdown of a micro benchmark. In this figure, y-axis shows the number of cycles. The first operation results in a page fault for misses. It requires both an exception and a trap. This is about 24% of the total execution time. We measure that a page fault requires about 18.5% more cycles for a 4 kilobyte I/O compared to a system call of the same I/O size. The second operation is related to the page fault handler, where the major part is the DRAM cache management. It requires about 18% of the total execution time. We measure that even in the case where the data already exists in DRAM, there is no need for an I/O, a single page fault requires about 1.13 microseconds. This is comparable to fast storage device access latency. The third operation is related to device I/O and requires about 49% of the total execution time. We use a premium device backed by DRAM to emulate an next-generation fast storage device and show only the remaining costs. Our approach in Aquila optimizes all of these operations. To understand why the exception and the trap are expensive, we are going to provide more details on the x86 architecture. In x86, we have four different protection domains. These are ring 0 to ring 3. Ring 0 is the most privileged domain where the operating system runs, and ring 3 is the least privileged domain where the application runs. Today, operating systems do not use rings 1 and 2. A page fault that happens in ring 3 requires both an exception and a trap. Page faults are a specific type of hardware exception that occur for invalid translation in the page table. A trap is also required because user applications run in ring 3, a low privileged domain. We measure that the hardware cost of a page fault that happens in ring 3 and includes both an exception and a trap to be about 1300 cycles. We also measure that the hardware cost of a page fault that happens in ring 0 to be about 600 cycles. These page faults include only the exception and they are commonly happening inside the operating system. A page fault in a protected domain without a trap incurs less than half of these costs. This is an important design aspect and Aquila tries to take advantage of this fact. Today, page faults are handled in ring 0 and user applications run in ring 3 for protection. For this reason, all operations in the miss path are expensive. This includes virtual address space manipulation, cache management, device I/O, and other management operations. We design and implement Aquila that uses ring 0 for performance and non-root mode for protection. In this case, page faults in ring 0 incur lower costs, and non-root mode still provides strong protection. To achieve this, we use hardware virtualization extensions. Intel VTX is a family of hardware virtualization extensions that targets the acceleration of virtual machine management. Except from the four traditional protection domains, it includes four additional protection domains, and they are separated into root and non-root mode. The root mode is intended to run the host operating system and the host application. The non-root mode is intended to run the guest. Even in this case, a transition from ring 3 to ring 0 in both modes requires a trap. In order to change mode, for example, from non-root to root mode, the VM exit is required. This is a heavier operation compared to a trap. We categorize storage cache management operations to common and uncommon path operations. Common path operations happen for every miss and they are handled in ring 0. These operations include virtual address space manipulation that happen with page faults, DRAM cache management to check if the page already exists in DRAM and also handle evictions and writebacks, and data transfers between DRAM and storage devices. Uncommon path operations happen at a lower frequency, but they require a VM exit. These include management operations such as file or device mappings with mmap and mmap system calls, and also physical memory management that includes the dynamic resizing of the DRAM cache. Both of these operations mainly happen during application initialization and do not change for large periods of time. In Aquila, common path operations do not require a protection domain switch, and this results in less cost in the common path. On the other hand, uncommon path operations with a VMX start heavier than before, but this is not an issue as they happen at a lower frequency. Today, the operating system runs in root ring 0, and user applications run in root ring 3. The main idea is that Aquila runs applications in non-root ring 0. This enables to handle all common path operations without the need for a protection domain switch and serve base faults in a trapless manner. Aquila also requires the host operating system to serve uncommon path operations. In this case, it requires a VM exit, and uncommon path operations are heavier than before. This is not an issue as uncommon path operations happen less frequently. Next, we are going to provide more details on common and uncommon path operations. The first operation is about trapless virtual memory manipulation. Today, user applications run in root ring 3 and require a protection domain switch to ring 0 to access storage devices. We move the user applications to non-root ring 0, and combined with Aquila, our library operating system will handle all common path operations without the need for protection domain switch. Aquila also provides a way to handle uncommon path operations with a VM call to the host operating system. In this case, the hardware cost to serve a page fault is about 600 cycles. Traditionally, this costs about 1300 cycles. This results in a reduction of 2.33 times. The second operation is related to DRAM cache management. This includes ideas from our previously published works like KMMap and FastMap. Similar to FastMap, it uses separate structures for clean and dirty pages. This enables scalable insert or remove operations combined with marking them as clean or dirty. Aquila uses an approximation of LRU for evictions and writebacks. Aquila also introduces a scalable NUMA-aware page allocator, which tries to allocate a page on the local NUMA node. This is required, as in Aquila, we reduce the miss path costs, and NUMA-related overheads are even more pronounced. The third operation is related to device I/O. The challenge here is that device access from non-root ring 0 requires the host operating system and results in increased cost due to the VM exits. To overcome this limitation, Aquila provides support for direct device access from non-root ring 0. This requires dedicated devices that is common today for database management systems and key value stores. Block addressable fast storage devices are mainly PCI Express attached. Aquila uses SPDK to map the device configuration registers direct to a library operating system. Byte addressable storage devices are mainly DIMM attached. In Aquila, we leverage DACs and we map them to the physical address spaces of our library operating system. Aquila supports both block and byte addressable storage devices and bypasses entirely the host operating system. Uncommon path operations required for management purposes. This includes the fourth operation about file or device mappings and the fifth operation about physical memory management. In terms of implementation details, Aquila uses Dune for cross-virtualization and also provides specific optimizations, for example, for running user applications in Ring 0. More details on the uncommon path operations and other implementation details can be found in our paper. Next, I'm going to talk about our experimental analysis. As a testbed, we use a server with two Intel Xeon processors at 2.4 GHz. This sums to 32 hyperthreads. We also use two different types of devices. We use an Intel Optane SSD and a PMM device backed by DRAM to emulate a next-generation fast storage device. Our server contains 256 GB of DRAM, both for memory and PMM emulation. It also runs CentOS 7.3 with Linux 4.14. For experimental analysis, we use micro benchmarks to show a targeted comparison with Linux memory mapped I/O. For storage applications, we use RocksDB, a state-of-the-art persistent key value store from Facebook. The common configuration is to use a user space cache and read-write system calls to interact with storage devices. RocksDB also provides an option to use memory mapped I/O. In this case, we use Linux, mmap, and Aquila. We also use YCSB with a 32 GB dataset and 8 GB of DRAM cache. Additionally, we evaluate Aquila in terms of extending the available DRAM over fast storage devices. In this case, we use Ligra, a graph processing framework. To achieve that, we translate all malloc and free calls to be over a memory mapped storage device and not DRAM heap. We use the BFS algorithm with a 64 GB dataset and 8 GB of DRAM cache. First, we compare Aquila with explicit read-write system calls and we provide an evaluation in terms of throughput using RocksDB. In this figure, x-axis shows the number of threads and y-axis shows the throughput in millions of operations per second. We show three bars here. The orange one is for RocksDB with Linux mmap, the blue one is for RocksDB with a user space cache and system calls, and the red one for RocksDB with Aquila. With a single thread, Aquila provides about 1.2 times higher throughput compared to a user space cache. With 8 threads, this increases to 1.4 times, and with 32 threads to 1.6 times. Aquila outperforms a user space cache with system call to access persistent storage. The benefits of Aquila compared to Linux mmap are even higher. With a single thread, Aquila provides 7.5 times higher throughput. With 8 threads, 7.2 times, and with 32 threads, 10.4 times higher throughput. This shows that Linux mmap is not appropriate for data-intensive applications, and Aquila overcomes these limitations. To understand where do these benefits come from, we provide a breakdown of storage cache management overheads. We show two bars, a user space cache configuration on the left and Aquila on the right. In both cases, we use RocksDB. Y-axis shows the number of cycles. Each bar consists of a purple part, which is about the I/O, a green part, which is about cache management excluding the I/O costs, and a light blue part, which is about the remaining cost of RocksDB. With a user space cache, 69% of the total execution time goes to cache management and cache accesses. With Aquila, we reduce this cost by 2.58 times, and this results in 43% of the total execution time. This leaves precious CPU cycles for further user processing. Next, we show how Aquila reduces miss cost overheads compared to Linux mmap. We provide the read page fault breakdown, which is the core part of the miss path in memory mapped I/O. We use a micro benchmark with a single thread that issues load instructions and randomly generated offsets. We ensure that each load instruction results in a page fault and also includes an I/O. Finally, we use a PMEM backed by DRAM to emulate a next generation fast storage device. We show two bars. The left one is for Linux and the right one for Aquila. Y-axis shows the number of cycles. A main benefit comes from the exception and the trap part, the light blue one. With Aquila, we remove the need to have a trap during page faults. This has an impact on operation one and we reduce the associated cost by 2.33 times. Aquila also optimizes the purple part, which is related to operation two, and the green part, which is related to operation three. More details on this can be found in our paper. Finally, we provide an evaluation for extending the application heap over fast storage devices. We use Ligra and the BFS algorithm. This figure shows the comparison for Linux mmap and Aquila. X-axis shows the number of threads and Y-axis shows the execution time in seconds. The orange bars show Linux mmap and the blue bars are for Aquila. With a single thread, Aquila reduced the execution time by 1.56 times, with 8 threads, 2.54 times, and with 16 threads, 4.14 times compared to Linux mmap. These benefits come from a large reduction in system and idle time by up to 8.3 times. To conclude, we propose Aquila, a novel memory mapped I/O path that significantly reduces I/O overheads and provides customization based on application needs. To achieve that, Aquila collocates application and memory mapped I/O path in on-root ring zero, a high privilege domain. This design enables a fast miss path and customization for both cache management and device access. We evaluate Aquila as a way to manage the storage cache and in order to provide heap extension over fast storage devices. With RocksDB, Aquila provides up to 40% increased throughput, and this comes from a reduction of up to 2.58 times in CPU cycles for cache management. With Ligra, Aquila results in up to 4 times reduction in terms of execution time. This concludes my talk. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions, you can reach me via email.